Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we'll learn how to add the fly-through text transitions seen at the start of this video. We'll use Motion 5 to make the custom title needed for this effect and add it to our project in Final Cut Pro. If you don't have Motion 5, I'll have the one we make today available for download from my website. Click the link in the video description, download and install a custom title, and skip to this part. For the rest of us, let's get started. Open up Motion and create a new title project. Set the frame rate and video resolution to match your project. The duration doesn't really matter, so you can leave this at the default 10 seconds. Click Open. First thing I always do is fit the canvas to the viewer window, just so I can see exactly what I'm working with. We won't need this background layer, so uncheck the box beside it in the Layers panel to disable it. Select the text layer, and in the inspector, center it in the text box. Select your font, and use a scale slider to make it nice and big. Go to the Properties tab, and make sure that X and the Y position values are at 0 to center your text in the viewer window. Click the position disclosure triangle to reveal the individual position controls. When you use most of the titles in Final Cut Pro, you have the ability to adjust the X and the Y position values, but you don't get the option to move your text on the Z axis. This is why we have to make this title in Motion. Click the down arrow on the right side of this control and select Publish. This will publish this control so you can adjust it in Final Cut Pro. While here, to make things easier, also publish the X and the Y controls, and to fade your text in at the start, publish the opacity control. Go up to the menu bar and select File and Save As. Give this custom title a name and select a category for it. Click Publish to make this title available in Final Cut Pro. To add the fly-through transition to your project, drop your first clip into the timeline and add the second clip above it, overlapping the two by a few seconds. Move your playhead back a few more seconds. Open the Titles and Generators browser and add your new title above the second clip. Select the title layer, change your text, and in the inspector, if needed, adjust any other parameters. If you want to fade your text in, move your playhead to the start of your title clip. Select the title inspector, bring the opacity slider all the way down to 0 and add a keyframe. Move your playhead forward about 10 frames and bring the opacity slider back up to 100. Move your playhead to the start of your second clip and add keyframes to all three position adjustments. Press the down arrow key to go to the end of your bottom clip and click and drag up the Z position value until one of your letters fills the entire screen. You may have to adjust the X value to center your text. Adjust these parameters until one of your letters completely covers the viewer window. Move your playhead back to the start of your title clip, go to the Generators browser, and from the Solids category, select the Custom Generator. Add this generator between the top two layers. Move your playhead to the start of the second clip, and with the generator clip selected, in the Video Inspector, add a keyframe to the opacity slider. Move your playhead to the end of your bottom clip, and bring the opacity slider all the way down. Select the Generators inspector and change the color of this generator to whatever you want your text color to be. I'll do white for this example. Go back to the title clip and in the Video inspector, change the blend mode to Stencil Alpha. And last, to bring this all together, command click your title clip, your generator clip, and the top video clip, and combine them all into one compound clip with a keyboard shortcut Option G. We'll let this render out, and here's our finished result. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting the like button or in the comments below. And if you're new here, I make videos like this every week, so please subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.